Members of Parliament under the Physical and Structure Committee joined the State Ministers of Economic Monitoring, Peter Ogwang, and Bunyola Affairs, Jennifer Namuyango, on the progress of roadworks carried out by the Uganda National Roads Authority in the Albertine region in the districts of Hoima, Masindi, Chikube, and Kakumiro districts. Of the roads that were inspected, Kabale Chizira Mfumbi is also expected to provide access to the Kabale International Airport that is being constructed in Hoima district. However, works on the 25-kilometer road have stalled after the process of acquiring a loan to facilitate completion of the road broke down.
You know, traveling with the ministers and members of parliament, because they then go back and on their end they help us move things.
In response, the State Minister of Economic Monitoring, Peter Ogwang, urged the legislators to fast track the loan application so that the roadworks can be completed.
So I'm going to write to my colleague, General Katumba Wamala, my sister here in charge, Bunyoro, then we invite UNRA and we meet with Minister of Finance specifically to address this matter. And that's why I'm happy with this kind of work.
I'm going to work with the Ministry of Works to make sure that we push finance, because it appears to be at the ministry level,
yes.
not parliament.
Not here.
Because for parliament, when a loan request comes, it just moves like a jet. We don't delay, because we know how critical these projects are to the economy.
For her part, the UNRA Executive Director, Allen Kajina, says the prolonged loan acquisition process has had cost implications for the contractor, which will trickle down to the taxpayers and government.
However, the invoices or the interim payment certificates, which he has been accumulating, are sitting accumulating interest. So on our side, our biggest concern one is how much we will have to pay as a country at the end because of the accumulating interest.
Meanwhile, Peter Ogwang has also said government needs to have a discussion about pre-financing of the road's construction by the contractors. When there is a delay by the government to pay back the money to the contractor in time, the roads end up being more expensive.
The question of pre-financing, like I'd already told you earlier on this morning, is one which in my own brief and report to the president, want to have an engagement, because technically we seem to be getting a lot of problems there, and it's important that we move in to see how to close the gaps. That's an area I'm going to take it up as far as this fieldwork is concerned.
The over 700-kilometer roads are being constructed in the Albertine region and are expected to have a major positive economic impact on the country, especially when the exploration of the oil starts. In addition, the money obtained from the sector will be able to facilitate some of the roads that are being acquired. Juma Kiria, NTV.